Stuart.
Happy birthday, Stuart.
Turning 65. Oh my gosh, you're catching up to us, all of us old people. We really wish we could be there with you on your big birthday, but sadly we are not there. So this is what we're doing, saying hello this way and hoping you're having a great day.
And you may be wondering why we're both wearing sunglasses. It's because we're imagining we're being there and blinded by all the candles on your cake. Anyway, all the best to you, buddy. We're privileged to have you as a friend.
Yeah.
For this many years, and hopefully for this many years, or that many years more. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Cheers.
Cheers
to you, Stuart.
Stuart is an example to all of us. He's a community member, he's a devoted husband, he's a gourmet chef, he's a travel agent, he does it all. He won our hearts, though, the day that he scaled the spruce tree between our two houses. I can't remember what he was going after, but for some reason, yep, he went up this tall tree and for a fair distance in cowboys. He won my undivided admiration, gold stars, amazement emojis, and some I have a memory I will never forget. Thank you, Stuart.
Seems like only yesterday we were celebrating your 60th, and here we are at 65. 1953. What a glorious year. A gallon of gas was 20 cents. You'd buy a new car for $1,600, and the price of a new house was only $9,500. The average earnings was $4,000. Can you imagine? $4,000 a year? And that was if you had a good paying job. Anyway, it was a wonderful year, and it was also the year that the color TV set was launched in North America. And I figured it was because you were born, because you've had a life of living color. And you've brought color to so many people's lives. You're a great guy, Stuart. I wish you a very, very happy, happy birthday and many, many more years of living in color to come. Cheers.
Hello, birthday boy. We are so thrilled, Lauren and I, to be able to send you wishes on this most epic day. There are so many things, Stuart, that I could say about you. You know, that you're such so kind of heart, you're a wonderful friend, you're a great dresser, you're incredibly intelligent, you're very interesting, a great conversationalist, and of course, an incredible navigator when we go on our motorcycle trips. But Stuart, we just wanted you to know that we love you and you are a most dear and valued friend. And I hope you have a super, super happy birthday down in Oregon. Happy birthday, my friend.
One of our favorite things about you, Stu, is you're such a wonderful host when we come to the coast. Besides being a wonderful brother, of course. But we've always had a wonderful time when we've come. You just go the extra mile, which is amazing. But the highlight is usually the food. You're such an amazing, amazing chef.
Well, just like your famous barbecued salmon, which is so delicious, and your Caesar salad, which is amazing.
For sure. Anyway, we're wishing you all the very best. We hope you have a wonderful birthday with all your family there. And we'll be thinking of you and send our love and hope someone else is doing the cooking for you. Happy birthday, pal.
Stuart.
Happy birthday.
It's that big day for you. I got to take you back to 1983. You were first trying to date Penny, my sister-in-law, and I thought, who is this guy? You know, he has this weird song that he plays continually, over and over, burning down the house. Give me a break. And then he skis in blue jeans, and I'm thinking, oh my God, his blue jeans are as frozen as you can get. And he, at dinner tables, when he had dinner, he'd fall asleep and he would still be listening to the conversations. I don't get it. But anyway, Stuart, it's your 65th, right here, 65 years old. So I'm gonna propose a toast, but before I do, I have got to say, you've been an amazing friend to me. You've been a great mentor. You have an amazing talent and you're very brilliant. And you're an amazing lawyer. So, Stuart, that's about all I can say about you right now, because I guess the rest of it is when I see you in person. So happy 65th birthday and all the best. I think that was an amazing vintage.
Hi, it's Scott.
And Verna.
We want to wish our funny,
witty,
hospitable,
charming,
talented
friend Stuart a very, very happy 65th birthday.
Hope to see you down here in the USA really soon. Happy birthday.
Bye.
Hi, Stuart. I have to read this because this is take two from the other night when I think I screwed up or something, or this just didn't work. So I have a script, and in honor of your birthday, I opened a very special wine for you, just in honor of you. I don't know if you can read that, because I sure can't. I hold it higher. There. Either you gotta be really good at reading backwards, or this is gonna come out looking forwards. Anyway, enough about that. It's gone now, Stuart. I had to finish it because, you know, I didn't want it to turn. It's really nice, though. It's too bad you couldn't have shared it with me, and maybe I'd let Penny have some. What was I going to say next? It's all over the place here. Oh, I won't tell you about that anymore because that part's over and done with. By the time, that bottle wouldn't have lasted anyway until your birthday, because it would have been really hard to get it to you. And I would have had to have drunken it. Drunk it. So, hope you're having a good time down there with everyone on your big B-Day. I was going to tell you that, I do have some wine to celebrate, just a little sippy. It's white, what can I say? You get more in with a straw anyway. Happy unbirthday to you, Stuart, because this isn't the real day. And I won't be there on the real day, but happy birthday. And, I was supposed to say my favorite thing about you. I shouldn't have to read this and just pop off the end of my tongue, but I guess one of the favorite things about you is you're just a wonderful secretary. I think Penny gets all my messages, which aren't that many anyway. You are a wonderful skier. Not that I've ever skied with you, but golfer and tennis. Tennis, I have played tennis with you. You're a good tennis player, Stuart. But most of all, I think that you are someone who appreciates fine wine and fine women. So, that I like. I'm signing off now. I need more of that wine. I think I'll go get another straw. So happy unbirthday and happy real birthday
Flying
to you.
To the moon. That is Jimmy Summers, Rick Rowan.
Bye now.
Then the Rippingtons.
Hi, Stuart. It's Barb weighing in to wish you a happy birthday. I hope you have a fabulous day. This is quite a milestone for you. I can't believe it, as we go back a lot of years. So anyway, Stuart, I hope your day is fabulous and the years that follow. The one thing I've always appreciated about you, Stuart, is your laugh, your sense of humor, and your steadfastness. Much love.
Happy 65th, Stuart. We all wish you a great day and a wonderful celebration. I hope you enjoy these video tributes. I'll start by saying that all my life, I've looked up to you, and not just literally. Your many accomplishments in law and community service have always amazed me, as well as how you've been able to balance all of this with time for family and friends. I don't know how you do it. It's amazing. I remember many wonderful times that we've had together over the years. As a kid, I remember you taking me to a video arcade in Kingston. How cool was that? I remember spending Thanksgiving weekend at your penthouse in Kingston. I remember the excitement of you coming home to London for Christmas holidays over my younger years. The most memorable time being when you came to London alone, without Penny, or so you thought. I remember traveling around the Scottish countryside with you in search of our Stuart roots. I remember a very special Christmas in Victoria when we skied and golfed in 2 days. How awesome. And I remember all the times that Dale, myself, and the kids have been able to get together with you and Penny in recent years. All wonderful memories. And throughout all this time, the thing that stands out to me, and something that I appreciate, is your sense of humor and your love of laughter. We wish you much happiness and laughter today as you celebrate. We love you lots, Stuart.
You're a wonderful commander, and it's lovely to be your friend. Thank you very much. You can sing this in English and in French.
Happy birthday! What we love most about Stuart Johnston is Grampy. We love our Grampy. He is an amazing human. He is an awesome guy, and we couldn't ask for anybody better. He's perfect.
We love you.
Love you.
Hi, Stuart. It's the ladies of the office.
Yay!
Drunk ladies. We're wishing you a happy birthday and hoping it's as special as you are.
Happy 65th birthday.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you.
You're beautiful. Don't ever change.
My favorite thing about Stuart is something that I admire about him. His love and affection for Penny and her two daughters, who are now his two daughters, and their children, his grandchildren. He's shown that devotion to that family in many ways over the years. It's quite an admirable quality. That's it.
My favorite thing about you, Stuart Johnston, is your relaxed and easy manner. This just great being with you. Every chance we get, we take. And what about that infectious laugh of yours? Now that's enough to get anybody going. We talk about you being a great chef and, well, a good athlete and all those wonderful other things about you, but we've been asked to keep it short. So happy birthday, Stuart.
Hey, Stuart. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. We've got 60 seconds to try and tell you how wonderful you are, and that's not nearly enough time. But I want to start with saying that from the minute we met you, your infectious laugh and smile really drew us in, as it does everyone. We've had 38 years of friendship and lots of laughs. Climbing a tree at 2 o'clock in the morning because somebody locked himself out.
A cake in the face while at your party for joining the bar.
A pie in my face. Thank you, Penny and Stuart.
Yeah.
But more than that, it's your integrity, it's your honesty, it's your warmth, and we are just so grateful for all of the years of friendship that we've had. Whether we see each other on a daily basis or not makes absolutely no difference. We just pick up right where we left off, and we love you.
Yeah.
So happy birthday. Hope you have a good one.
Happy birthday, Stuart.
Hey, Stuart, how you doing? Congratulations, my old friend. As I look at it, I think I have known you for more than half of my life. Now that's saying a lot, because that's a long time. Anyway, you've come from a young lawyer that I knew to a very successful lawyer, philanthropic, and cherished and loved in his community. And that says a lot as a lawyer. You also knew you as a young man. And now you are a happy grandfather, so that is something. Anyway, Marilyn and I will always be there for you, buddy, and I congratulate you Although I won't be there unless you just slow down a tad with skiing so I can catch up. Okay. Happy birthday. I know.
Happy birthday, Stuart. I think the best way to express myself is through song. I've been working on my voice, and I have a song that I think best captures how I feel, and I'm gonna sing that song. So here we go. I've just got the band here, piano player. It's in my dining room. It's gonna be good. Stuff. Oh. Happy birthday, man.
Hello, Stuart. One of the things I've always admired about you is your sense of leadership. I remember the time you led me into the temptation of KT-22 in Heavenly Valley.
Oh, and that's that adventuresome spirit that you have, Stuart. Oh my gosh, the activities you pursue, and not to mention that golf club. You will win yet.
Stuart is adventurous, isn't he? Stuart, I remember your adventurous nature when we were in Tuscany and you tried raw sausage at Dario Cecchini's butcher shop.
And those quirky gourmet themes. Ah, what fun we've had experiencing all the food that you prepare.
Oh, sure. And things like in your culinary prowess of cooking an entire suckling pig in your oven at home.
And there's that Ziggy whistle that I just love. And don't call me shortly.
Not to mention Stuart's unrelenting quest for that perfect martini.
Stuart, we love you so much, and we'd like to wish you the very happiest 65th birthday.
Absolutely. And we'd also like your ability to bring friends and family together for special occasions and enjoyment.
And we're so wishing you the very best of the best. Happy birthday, Stuart.
This is Bill Peacock, your retired Marine Colonel from Redwood City, California. There are so many favorite things I have about Stuart Johnston. The one superlative, though, is that from the instant you meet Stuart Johnston, and every time you talk to him, every time from thereafter, you have this feeling of confidence, knowing that he is confident in what he does and his own training and his perceptions, and you have the confidence that he will do the absolute best he can do for you. He's a remarkable guy, and my hope is that someday he will be the Prime Minister of Canada. Thank you, Penny, for giving me this opportunity to speak on Stuart Johnston's behalf. I'll be happy to travel there if he decides to run.
Well, happy birthday, my friend. 65 years, and oh, what a life you've led.
can't believe how much you do in a day and in your lifetime. As you know how bloody challenged I am with my telephone because you help me out so much. I don't know how I'm going to ever get this sent in time. I've procrastinated enough. I've had 2 weeks to do it. Now I'm getting it done, but I don't know how I'm going to get it uploaded or whatever the hell I'm going to do with it. But anyway, thank you for being my friend. Thank you for being my biggest cheerleader in the world. And please know, and I think you know, how much of a cheerleader I am for you too. You inspire so many people to do such the right thing, and you do so much for our community, for our city, and for the Order of St. John, which I'm a part of. You've made so many people happy, especially your beautiful wife. And thank you for allowing me to share her with you. And she makes my days happy too. Enjoy your time. Enjoy your birthday. You're only getting younger. Can't believe you're 65 years old. Of course, I'm always going to be older than you. And love you, big guy. Thanks for all you do for me. And God, I hope I can upload this bloody little video I'm doing for you. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.
Hi, Stuart. I have known you for more than 25 years. And what have I learned about you? Well, you're an amazing friend in person. You are a fabulous chef. You are a great husband. And you're definitely the snappiest dresser in all of Victoria. Cheers. Happy birthday. Love, Peter and Allie.
Hey, Stuart. Happy 65th birthday to you. We are so fortunate to have met you and Penny. Always enjoy getting together with you guys. You are the consummate gentleman and always a pleasure. Also love skiing with you, and I hope that the knees, both of our knees, will allow us to continue in the future.
Sir Stuart, my favorite 65-year-old Canadian, I think we met 9 years ago in Sun River, and I have appreciated your being my friend throughout the years, and look forward to spending many more with you. Happy, happy birthday. Bye.
Happy birthday.
Hi, Stuart. It's your international drinking buddies, Frank
and Renee. We wish we could be with you to celebrate your birthday.
But until we're together again, we want to wish you all the best for health and happiness.
So today, we raise a wee dram to you. Here's hoping you have a very happy 65th birthday. Slangeva!
Hi, Stuart.
Hi.
We're here in beautiful Sun River. Very lucky to be able to enjoy your 65th birthday and celebrate that with you.
Well, we are very thankful for you to have invited us to Sun River and to share this special place with us, because there's so many fun things we can do. Like, we go to the river float, we go to the shark, play lots of games, even though you might not like them. and also play some sports like tennis, pickleball, golf.
And he's the reigning champion right now in pickleball.
Yes, yes, he is. And I would like to especially thank you for teaching me all of the four-letter words when playing golf. Exactly. Anyway, we're just so happy to be here. And, you know, you've always been such great supporters of me and the girls. And when I didn't believe in myself, you always believed in me. And just always been there, and so wonderful to share memories with, and good conversation, and great wine, and great food, and
all the good stuff.
All the good things, exactly. And there's something that, you know, always reminds me of you, and so you have a great love for music, and so this is kind of back from when we first met, Stuart. So I thought we'd leave with this little chime. Time to get out.
Anyway, happy 60th birthday. Love you.
Hi, Stuart. Happy birthday, Stuart.
Stuart, I have a concern. I don't think you have a booking to get to be this age.
Remembering with fondness all our travels, and especially South Africa, where we really didn't have a booking to have our dinner.
I didn't realize that when Maria asked me to stand here, that I'd be a reflection with the wonderful lights above, but that's a reflection on aging, that sometimes our hairlines change a bit. That's a good thing, because it shows all the experience you've had over the years and the enjoyment you've provided to all the other people.
And always, I look up to my elders, and you always will be an elder, Stuart. So very happy, happy, happy 65th, and looking forward to many, many more happy ones, and for me to be around to wish you a happy birthday for those.
Much love and best wishes, and I didn't know that Maria looked up to me. All the best. Lots of love to everybody.
Take care. Happy birthday.
Bye now.
Hi, Stuart. It's Lisa. I just wanted to say happy 65th birthday to such an amazing guy. You are a man of such integrity and passion and compassion. And it's been just an absolute joy and pleasure to know you all these wonderful years, whether it's been sitting around the dining room table, sharing wonderful food or wine, being in the company of you in your office when you've had to help us out with business things. You are just such a beautiful soul. You inspire so many people to be good and to be kind and to be honest and be reliable and be patient, such as yourself. And I wish I was there in person to give you a big, gigantic hug and just say, wow, you look, make 65 look amazing. And I hope you have a wonderful time in Sun River with your family. And again, happy, happy birthday to you, Stuart. Keep on doing all the wonderful things that you do, living life to its fullest. And I hope to see you soon, and just have a wonderful 65th year. Lots of love. Smooch, smooch. Happy birthday.
Hi, Stuart. Happy birthday. Can't believe 65. You look 55, and I'm not just saying that. This is hard for me because there's lots of favorite things about you. So many. I mean, we hit it off so good at the beginning, and we've been close ever since, whether we get to see each other or not, or talk much or not. We'll always have that bond. My favorite thing is, well, you're an amazing cook, you're an amazing husband to my mom. There's so many amazing things about you. You're smart, you're successful, and you're handsome. It's wow. But you have been an amazing role model in my life, in Renee's life, for such a long time. And Dad is just a word. You're more than that. And I love you very much, and I hope you have a wonderful birthday.
Mwah. Yes, he's a great guy. We've had good times together. He loves red wine and lots of it.
And a little scotch.
And a little scotch on occasion.
Yeah,
or gin or whatever happens to be around. And we've spent time with Stuart in Glasgow in 2017 and attended the Royal Edinburgh Tattoo.
Great times together.
And then in 2018, quite recently, we were in Helsinki, Finland. We were at the Sovereign Council meeting in Tampere, Finland. And then we spent a wonderful 10 days on a Baltic tour with good times and lots of wine.
And lots of listening to our guide. But here we are in a pub. Good times in the pub we had as one example. That's lunch hour.
That was one example.
And then
here's another example.
Meal. Another elegant meal with our traveling companions. But we had a wonderful time. There was even a little drinking on the bus, if I remember correctly.
Yes.
Right?
So we could get together here and wish Stuart a happy birthday to a young 65-year-old.
Yes.
And wish him at least another 65 years.
So happy birthday, Stuart.
Happy birthday, Stuart.
Happy birthday. I hope you have a great day on your 65th, and I wish I could be there with you guys. But unfortunately, I'm stuck at home working. So have fun on that day and play lots of tennis for me and games, because I know you love those. And lots of martinis, of course, because we know you like martinis. So everyone make Grampy a martini on his birthday, please. but I can't wait to see you guys when you get home and celebrate with you then. I love and miss you guys all lots, and I hope you have a great day today, Grampy. Love you. Bye.
Hey, Stuart. This is Ann and Rick and Cody, too. Say hi, Cody.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy 65.
My favorite part of Grampy is how much he cares, and he always wants to help out others with being a lawyer and everything, and he's just been such an awesome grandpa and an awesome dad for so long, and I love you so much, Grampy, and I hope you have an amazing birthday. You deserve it. Bye!